That's right. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. Actually, it's 9 o'clock Eastern Time, 9:03. Welcome to Friday Night Bonfire with Rockin' Randy.
And the amazing Moondog.
Yes, the Moondog is an Italian. Thank you for everybody tuning in tonight. We just want to know that it's going to be a nice, relaxing night. We're all going to sit around the campfire. Okay, thanks for Moondog. You got the log in the fire. It started. All right, okay. Got a great night lined up for you. First of all, Moondog, tell me what our feature is.
Oh my God, one of my all-time favorite artists, Mr. Jimmy Buffett, the king of the long weekend. We've got a great show lined up for you tonight. We'll play a lot of Jimmy songs. We've got a lot of other interesting stuff we're going to do tonight. More campfire stories, campfire songs.
Oh, that was it. Pretty well. We got we have some campus fire stories for you. Now, don't forget, we also have the two news people.
Of course, that can't go without Norman Herman doing the news. Doctor Strange up with the weather.
Norman, you back there? Okay, anyway, we want to thank those who tuned in so far. It's going to be a good night. We're going to have lots of sing-alongs. So get those vocal cords ready. They would have been a little strumming on the guitar, but we're going to leave the singing to the real musicians tonight. Also, we got the top 15 campfire songs of all time. Little stories on those, and there's no kidding. Music in there. So, anyway, on to the music. This is James Blunt, Bonfire Heart, an RJ's classic mix.
It's another Friday night with Rockin' Randy.
Rockin' Randy.
And the amazing Moondog.
The amazing Moondog.
Blending the best music together on RJ's classic mix.
Shocking Blue Venus. RJ's classic mix. And you're listening to Friday Night Bonfire with Rockin' Randy and
the amazing Moondog.
Amazing Moondog. Okay, and that's that. We also heard from America, Sister Goldner. Bob Seger started off with Night Blues. We heard from Shocky Blue, Venus, that was the last song. We also heard the number 15 song in our top campfire songs of all time list. That was Tony Wilberry's Handle of Care. Now, I think it's time for some little campfire story here. Before I go any further, John, you've gone camping lots, right? When you were little, do you ever remember saying, don't walk off too far in the woods?
Oh, yeah, I heard that all the time from the parental unit way back in the day when I was
really
tall.
That's right. You know, don't walk too far, you'll get lost. Well, this all reminds me of the unfortunate story of a British entrepreneur, John Tate, and his compass. Yeah. Now, sometime back in the mid-1800s, a small-time British manufacturer named John Tate decided to go into business of making compasses. Set up a factory, installed the machinery, hired some workers, and began turning out his first compasses. Now, he had just completed his first batch of 500 compasses when someone finally pointed out that he made a mistake. You know what that mistake was?
What did he do?
He forgot to mark which end of the compasses was going. No, the compass worked fine. He just knew which way was north and which way was south.
So, it's kind of a deal breaker.
That is. So needless to say, that they're poor. Compasses didn't sell. He went bankrupt. The factory closed. The workers were laid off. Sad, but his memory lives on. Since that time, any compass where you're not sure which end is north and which is south has been known as a Tate's compass. And you know what the moral of the story is?
Tell me.
Is that who has a Tate's is lost. Back to the music in RJ's classic mix, Rock and Randy, the amazing Moondogs with you on a Friday night bonfire. Simon and Guy are from Cecilia. Hey, listeners, did you know RJ's classic mix supports both amateur and professional musicians? Whether you're a budding soul artist struggling to reach that perfect note or doing weekend gigs with a gang and have that first CD ready to go, we can help. Send us your demos and we'll promote them on our station. And the best part, it's absolutely free. Just don't forget us when you sign that big first recording contract. Call us at 613-766-7724 and let RJ's Classic Mix spread the word, or should we say, music. All right, fruitcakes and every one of us. Jimmy Buffett, our featured spotlight guest tonight. You'll listen to Friday Night Bonfire with Rockin' Randy.
And the amazing Moondog.
And RJ's Classic Mix. Now, before we move on, just like that last set, we did also hear from Simon of Garfunkel, Cecilia. We heard from Soul Asylum, Runaway Train. And we did a little feature band on our support group there that we have, is, you know, regarding if you're an amateur musician out there, you want to get some air time and stuff like that, you know, we'll definitely do it for you. But anyway, this gentleman's name is John McClurg, introduced to me by a good friend at work, Kevin. And thank you for that. We'll be playing more of his music in the future. But anyway, I digress. Mr. Bojangles, the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band. You're listening to R&J's classic mix, Friday Night Bonfire with Rock and Ready, and
The Amazing Bulldog.
Okay, now in that set, we heard a couple of songs, or a song that you may have not heard for a long time. I thought, why is he playing that? King Tut, Steve Martin, and the Toot Uncommons. We followed that up with Mr. Bojangles by the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band. Now, what do you suppose, Bulldog, that those two songs do have in common?
I don't know.
You don't know? Interesting. Well, Martin's little backup band there, the Toot Uncommon. We're actually the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band.
No!
Yes! So we thought we'd tie that in together.
That's awesome, I didn't know that.
And it's a little trivia we throw out there, so if you guys out there, next time you hear King Tut, the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band in the background. Okay, we'll jump your head.
Got a Congo made of soda.
That's right. And now, it's time for another review of the Amazing Moondog.
This week, The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly takes a look at Thor, the Dark World. This second outing for Marvel's God of Thunder sees Thor taking on an ancient foe bent on shrouding the universe in darkness, reuniting with his love, Jane Foster, and forging an unlikely alliance with his trickster half-brother, Loki. Let's get to it and see if lightning can actually strike twice. What's good? I missed this one in theaters, and I really wish I could have seen it in 3D, but the Blu-ray version is pretty spectacular. What I liked the most about this movie was the visuals. When I watched the original Thor, I wanted to see more of the adventure take place on Asgard and the other nine realms, and this sequel delivers what I really needed. Epic battle scenes, chock full of gods versus dark elves, airships bristling with laser cannon fire, and lots of scenes of Thor clobbering the baddies with his enchanted Uru hammer, Mjolnir. That kind of brings me to what's bad. While the 10-year-old kid that's still inside me had a blast with the visuals, the nearly 40-year-old me had to ask, is that all you got? And the answer is pretty much yeah. Chris Hemsworth is still good as Thor, and shows a more humble and mature side to the old Hammer Slayer. But I have to say, of all the Marvel movies, Thor has got to have the weakest supporting cast. Jane Foster, her intern Darcy, and physicist Erik Selvig all return, but don't really offer anything really new, except to be used as plot devices and cheap laughs. I'm hoping for the next Thor movie, or maybe the follow-up to the Avengers, they either make this trio more interesting and critical to the story, or just leave them out. The gods of Asgard alone are far more interesting than this trio. And lastly, here's the other one. This time I'd say it's the villain of the piece, Malekith, Lord of the Dark Elves. And it's not because he's ugly, which he is, but because of the treatment of the character. He's introduced as a foe from ancient days of Asgard who wants to return the universe to the darkness that once existed. That's pretty much it. He sees a red door and he wants it painted black. We don't know anything about this guy except that he's supposed to be the bad guy. And a fabulous actor, Christopher Eccleston, is wasted here, covered up in makeup and speaking a weird elf language through most of the film, and barely interacting with any of the major cast. But we do get to see him yell at and kill a lot of his own people. Two Thor films and the Avengers down, and we still have yet to see important characters like the Enchantress, the Executioner, or Baldur the Brave make an appearance. Ah well, better luck next time, Marvel. So that's it for now, true believers. Catch you next time for The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly.
Gee, Yogi, what you doing?
Hey, boo-boo, I'm listening to R&J's classic mix. These boys pack more hits than a fully stocked picnic basket.
Well, that's great, Yogi.
Jeez, boo, would it kill you to just smile once in a while?
All right, you're listening to Friday Night Bonfire, and that's our spotlight artist tonight, Mr. Jimmy Buffett. Now, of the over 30 albums that Mr. Buffett has released over the years, 8 of them are gold albums, 9 platinum and multi-platinum, and he received his very first ever Country Music Award in 2003 for the very first song he played tonight, his duet with Alan Jackson, It's 5 O'Clock Somewhere. But, for all that, way back in 1970, his very first album called Down to Earth, and that was released by Andy Williams' record label, Barnaby Records. and it included the song we just heard, Captain America, Mr. Jimmy Buffett's tribute to the Star-Spangled Man with the Flight Hat. Now, up next, we're going to hear one from Liz Jones Baez, her version of the band, They Might the Go Old Dixie Down, which is one my family used to sing around the campfire way back in the day. This one goes out to Mama Muda. Thanks for listening.
It's an adventure on RJ's Classic Mix. You listen to Friday Night Bonfire. It's good at bonfires. You always have to have a story. Moondog around a campfire, don't you?
Story time!
It's story time! Now, one hot and very, very dry day in the wild, wild west. This dog walks into the saloon and says, "Give me a beer." Now, evidently, Moondog, this type of thing wasn't too rare around those parts, because the bartender said, "I'm sorry, but we don't serve dogs here." The dog looked out and took out a silver dollar. I don't know where from, why you don't know where dogs keep pockets, but anyway, dropped it on the bar and said, "Look, I got money, and I want a beer." The scene had the potential to get a tad ugly, like it did back in the old west day, guns come out and stuff like that. The bartender, getting a little irate, said, "One more time, we do not serve dogs here. Please leave." So, the dog growled. The bartender pulled out a gun and shot the dog in the foot. Can you imagine? The dog yelped and ran out the door. Now, the very next day, Moondog, the swinging bar doors were tossed open, and in walks the dog that had been in the saloon the day before. You can imagine. But this time, he was dressed all in black. A black cowboy hat, a black vest, three black cowboy boots, and one black bandage. The dog looks around, waits for all the talking to settle down, says, "I'm looking for the man who shot my paw."
Womp, womp, womp. That's pretty good, actually.
Yes, and that is our story for the night. And now, with the latest in news and weather, here's Norman Herman and Dr. Strangelove, only on The Mix.
Good evening, this is Norman Herman reporting. A pregnant woman and her boyfriend claim they found an extra ingredient in their Happy Meal, marijuana. The couple were sharing a cheeseburger and noticed it didn't taste like typical Mickey D's product. 23-year-old Brittany Sanger says, "Once I opened the burgers, you couldn't smell McDonald's anymore, only illegal drugs." The couple reported the McDoobies to their local Ottumwa, Iowa police. The officers have sent the substance away for complete testing and report the green substance appears to be consistent with marijuana. According to CBS San Francisco, an electronic sign reading, "Godzilla Attack, Turn Back," was spotted on Van Ness Avenue. But, not to fear, the U.S. Air Force believes it could stop an assault by giant rogue wizards. Even though other government agencies have proven themselves unable to stop hackers from tampering with road signs. Earlier this week, a similar road sign referred to the Jersey Shore as Asheville Next Left. After a hair-raising week, the family of legendary DJ and voice actor Casey Kasem has reported that he has finally been located in Washington State. There is a dispute between the ailing actor's family and his wife over who has control over his health care. Kasem's daughter Carrie has had him declared missing earlier this week and looks forward to his return to Los Angeles. Kasem suffers from a form of dementia called Lewy body disease. So I guess I wraps up that mystery. White Scoop, White Norman. I'm Norman Herman, and that's news to me.
Alright, everybody, so keep listening to RJ's Classic Mix, or they play a little bit of everything, don't you know? Except for that rap music. You won't hear none of that hippin' and a hoppin' or that bippin' and a boppin'.
You're listening to Friday Night Bonfire and RJ Classic Mix with Rockin' Randy and
the Amazing Moondog.
Okay, and in that last set, we did manage to get in our on our list of our top 15 campfire songs of all time.
At number 13,
we heard Hotel California by the Eagles.
And
we heard Dave Gilmore's live version of Wish You Were Here. But more important, we also have from our featured Spotlight band tonight. And Moondog's going to tell us a little more about that.
Yeah, the last song we heard was another one from our Spotlight artist, Mr. Jimmy Buffett. King of the Long Weekend, and Island Hopper he is. But back in the early days, before he traveled off to his favorite stomping grounds in St. Bart's, he moved from New Orleans to Denver, Colorado, and that's when we heard that last song, A Mile High in Denver, which was also from his very first album from 1970, the same one that we played earlier, his song about Captain America. So, there we go, a little bit more on Jimmy Buffett. And, yeah, I thought those last two songs kind of tie in together with our philosophizing with Floyd section we heard, which we heard with David Gilmour, going into A Mile High in Denver, so, you know, whatever, if you're drinking beer and if you have some other kind of favorite enhancement, hope you're having a good night by the campfire like we are.
Thank you, Moondog. Great review. And all I can say is everyone had a good time, and I'm glad those that are listeners have tuned in to our bonfire night. On to the music. Yep. I met with you, Modern English. Appropriate song. If you happen to get a little stumbling drunk and fall into the fire, I guess, and take your loved one with you, you would melt with them, so I melt with you. You're listening to RJ's classic mix Friday night bonfire, and I have a question for the Moondog. Moondog, what do you do when you see a full moon?
Oh, there's only one thing I do. I bark at the moon. Ow! La 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 la.
Oh, yeah, we're back. Sorry. It's a Friday night bonfire, and we're just cooking up some hits. That was Simon and Garfunkel with the Boxer. And during the break, we had a couple of hot dogs cooked up on the bonfire here. We're thinking about breaking out the marshmallows, and what's up next, Randy?
Well, marshmallows. Are marshmallows considered a fruit?
I don't know. Marshmallows, maybe.
Marshmallows, yes.
Are they from Mars?
Anyway, campfire story time. Boys and girls.
Love stories!
Now, Moondog, there was this young boy traveling on a long, long train trip across Canada, obviously on VIA, which we hear go by every half hour here. Sitting across from him was an older man, very neatly and precisely dressed. Across his knees, he carried a briefcase, upon which he nervously drummed his fingers. Since he looked to be rather an angry sort of man, the boy didn't bother to start the conversation.
I wouldn't either.
So presently, the man opened his briefcase, took out two paper napkins, a pocket knife, and an apple. Carefully, he peeled and cored the apple. He placed all the peelings on one of the two napkins and folded it into a neat parcel. Then he moved his briefcase to one side, stood up, and walked to the end of the couch. Now, the little boy, by craning his neck, the boy was able to watch him move out into the little platform at the end of the car and throw the parcel of peels onto the track.
That's odd.
It is. So when he returned, he touched his hand, sat down, and lifted the briefcase back up across his knees. Picked up the peeled and cored apple, carefully cut it into thin slices, placed the slices onto a second napkin, and made a similar neat little parcel. Now, to the boy's amazement, he then repeated his routine. He moved to the end of the couch, threw the parcel on the line, and when he returned, he picked up his briefcase, took out two more napkins and an orange, which he began to peel.
What the heck?
Now, the man, having all kinds of fruit one at a time from his case, peeled each piece and threw away the first peel and rolled it. So, after all, the young boy couldn't contain himself. He said, simply, I'd asked the man what he was doing. He says, what are you doing there, buddy? Like, what's with this stuff? Just, I'm not getting a fruit salad. Then why'd you keep throwing it away? Just kind of angered the man. He turns and like, snaps his, I think it should be rather obvious. I'm throwing it out because I don't like fruit salad. Here is an RJ's classic mix. Me. Not want to go home because we're having such a good time around the bonfire. You're listening to Friday Night Bonfire on RJ's Classic Mix with Rockin' Randy and
Amazing Moondog.
And that was the bet. Harry Belafonte, Dale. Now that was number 11 on our top campfire songs of all time. And every time I hear that song and Moondog will agree, I think of that movie Beetlejuice with the table scene and the people's faces getting grabbed and dancing to that song. Anyway, our featured spotlight artist tonight was Jimmy Buffett, and here's Moondog to tell you more.
Yes, again, back to our featured spotlight, Mr. Jimmy Buffett. Now, as I mentioned earlier tonight, he does a lot of different things. He's not just a singer-songwriter. He dabbles in this and that.
And he's actually written three number one bestsellers, including Where is Joe Merchant and Tales from Margaret Peterville. His 1998 book, A Pirate Looks at 50, went straight to number one on the New York Times bestseller list. And as an actor, he's had guest appearances on the rebooted version of Hawaii Five-0. And he's actually playing a character who's a helicopter pilot that he created for his novel, Where is Joe Merchant? So it's kind of like a comic book crossover where worlds are colliding and all kinds of cool stuff happens. Anyway, he was also offered a cameo role in the very first Pirates of the Caribbean movie, Curse of the Black Pearl, but he declined to participate in that. Now, he also owns a chain of restaurants, one of which is called Cheeseburger in Paradise, and he also owns the Margaritaville Cafe. And tonight, yours truly, the Amazing Moondog, has been wearing his patented, copyright-claimed Jimmy Buffett Margaritaville toque that he purchased when he had his birthday last year at the Niagara Falls, Ontario Margaritaville. So, on that note, here's the very delicious and greatest hit, Cheeseburger in Paradise.
Ah, early in a love song. Marshall Tucker Band. Friday night bonfire. Actually, it's Saturday a.m. early bonfire here on out east in Kingston, Ontario. I'm rocking Randy and RJ's Classic Mix. Tonight with me is the
Amazing Moondog, sitting here by the fire in the cold of Woodland, but the fire still burning.
That's right. Okay, now, to continue with our top 15 list, this is number 9. Oh, this is all campfire songs. This is number 9, Take Me Home, Country Roads, John Denver, and RJ's Classic Mix.
All right, that was our spotlight artist tonight, Jimmy Buffett, and that was his classic song, A Pirate Looks at 40, and let me tell you, I've been listening to this song for a lot of years now, and the closer I'm reaching on 40, the lot clearer the words in this song seem to me. So, Savvy, what we got next, Randy?
And now, the very first song video ever played on MTV, only in RJ's Classic Mix. Rockin' My Life Away, the King Bees on RJ's Classic Mix. It's 1:30 a.m. Eastern Time here in Kingston, Ontario. With me, I'm Rockin' Randy, and with me, of course, is
Boom, doggy daddy,
did you? Yeah, Friday night, that's a long weekend, Victoria Day weekend, and we want to wish everybody out there a happy and safe week. Long weekend, that extra day off is like godsend, and we want to thank you for all the tuning in tonight. We're going to keep the music going with a little Led Zeppelin on RJ's Classic Mix.
It's your Friday night bonfire, and that was our spotlight star tonight, Jimmy Buffett, with My Head Hurts, My Feet Stink, and I Don't Love Jesus. And I know, at the end of a long weekend, on occasion, I have felt that way myself. Have you not, Rockin' Randy?
Oh, I think every long weekend except one.
Yeah. So, yeah. God bless Mr. Jimmy Buffett.
Mr. Jimmy Buffett, our feature. And thank you for our listeners for tuning in. We're going to keep the music going with a little bit of Harry Chapman for you. Another story to tell. Taxi on RJ's Classic Mix.
All right, you're listening to the Friday Night Bonfire. That was the Kentucky Headhunters with Miss Walker. And now, sad to say, it's around that time. You don't have to go home, but you can stay here. We're going to... I suppose tonight we're going to just wait till the bonfire dies down. We're not pushing the tables out of the way or the chairs up on top of it. So. Anyway, glad you're all here tonight. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. You're right. And we'll be back next Friday night with our Friday Night Boogie Part 6. And Rock and Randy will be back next Saturday with Saturday Night Jukebox. But thank you for all tuning in. Enjoy the long weekend. I'm Rock and Randy, and with me was
the Amazing Moondog.
That's right. Thank you for tuning in. And now it's closing time with Leonard Cohen.
Good night, everybody. Love you all.